Father, in the name of Jesus, I give you glory, I give you honor. As I share your word this day, use me as a vessel to be a blessing to your people. May the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be pleasing to you, O God. In Jesus' name, amen, amen. My name is Florence Minor, welcoming you to yet another time of Celebrate Your Moment with Joy. And this is a program of One Word Digital Media, and I'm broadcasting live all the way from Minnesota, USA, and I hope you'll be blessed. The title of my message will be, Do Not Give Up on Your Assignment, No Matter What. We are in the season of Easter, when we know the story or remember the story of how Jesus went through hard situation for your sake and for my sake. And the verses of reference will be Matthew 27, verse 55 to 56. I'll read in Jesus' name. It says, And many women who had come from Galilee with Jesus to care for him were watching from a distance. Among them were Mary Magdalene, Mary, the mother of James and Joseph, and Zebedee's wife, the mother of James and John. May the Lord bless his word. Many people, men and women, followed Jesus, but some of them feared because of what was going on. They feared for their life, and they forgot that we should only fear he who is able to destroy both our body and our spirits, and that is God. Because this body we are in is a tent, and time and again it becomes weak and it falls off, like when you are sick. Can you give up on your assignment because of sickness? Oh no, do not give up, because the grace of God will be sufficient. I'm running as I continue in this life and journey in my Christian faith, that there are some words that we do not even to tell those we love when they are in problem. Do not tell them, I am sorry, or in what we say, pore, or I feel for you. Whenever you see that someone is going through struggle, just encourage them. I like the way the words we have read states. These women followed afar off, caring for Jesus. You can't care for somebody when you are showing some facial impression of disappointment. The nature of my job is that even when the situation looks like they are so bad, you still show somebody there is hope, because you are there to take care for them, to encourage them. And I want to believe that just like we are parents, we are employees, we are employers, we are ministers of the gospel, whatever responsibility you've been given. It is good to know that the worst thing you can do is see, for example, a kid is falling and then you shout, I do that and later on I regret. Because you should tell, oh, it's okay, it's gonna be okay, it's gonna be okay. Even when you see like they are breathing, then you take care of them. Jesus went through a situation. But I thank God for these women that are mentioned, Mary Magdalene and Mary, the mother of James, the mother. Let me just read it again. I am sorry about that. Among them were Mary Magdalene, the mother of James and John, and Zebedee's wife, the mother of James and John. I love the courage of these women. I don't see men there. And I'm talking to somebody. Even though we are in the Easter season, it is good to remember that though many other people may give up on the way, it is our assignment, it is our responsibility to encourage such. Keep on moving, and somebody will be encouraged by your determination. Somebody will be encouraged by your focus. Somebody will be encouraged by your courage of not giving up. Do not give up, because he who has called you is faithful. These women, and when Jesus rose again on a Monday, the Easter Monday, they celebrated with joy all the rising of the Savior. How about those who gave up on the way because they were afraid? afraid of their arrival. They had to join in. Maybe they looked afar and said, oh, I think it's adding up to something. Can you be that person who is so much focused on your assignment until somebody who is giving up can say, oh, I think there's something is coming up well, and I'm going to keep on. I'm going to follow. May God help you and help me so that we can keep up to our assignment. We keep on holding to those nails scared hands, even as a singer sang and said, keep on holding, no matter what may come your way, for soon the journey will be over. I hope someday you will soon be grand when you keep on holding to those nails scared hands. Yes, Jesus went through a lot. When the ninth hour came, it was not easy. He drank of that cup. But hallelujah to the Lamb of God, because on the third day he rose. On the third day there was celebration. Oh, on the ninth hour there was darkness. But darkness came to light when death was defeated. Oh, death had no power. Whatever you could be going through that seems like death, I want to tell you it is permanent. Your rising day is coming. Your that day is coming. May the Lord help you to stay focused to your assignment without giving up. Let us pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, thank you for reminding us that we need to stay focused without distraction on what you've called us to do. Despite the many scaring things on the way, despite the many scaring reports, despite the being left by dear ones, oh Lord, help us to know where we have come from and where we are heading. And because on the third day, Jesus, you rose, our situations are going to rise up. Our marriages will rise up. Our children will rise up to moral behaviors. Oh, our jobs will be elevated because you are the one who promotes us. Oh, Jesus, I thank you. Oh, may you minister to that one who is sick and feeling like there is no hope. May you minister to that one who is giving up in what you had called them initially to do. May they know that day is coming, even as we are in this Easter season. In Jesus' name, amen. May the Lord bless you. You are there. You have never trusted the Lord. What a season for you to trust the Lord. Jesus went through all the hard situation for your sake and for my sake. Otherwise, if we were all saints, he could not have died on the cross. He died for you. You are forgivable. It doesn't matter what you have done. If you're in that category and you feel like you're unforgivable, this is your time. Do you want to say this prayer after me for repentance? Lord Jesus, I thank you for this Easter season when we remember how you suffered. I appreciate what you did for me, and in that, I'm accepting you to be my Lord and Savior. Write my name in the book of life. Give me a desire to grow spiritually, oh Lord, in Jesus' name. Amen. If you have prayed that prayer, you have become a new creature. You become a Christian by faith. Next step, look for a church nearby where you live that teaches the full gospel without compromise, where you'll be able to grow spiritually. When you go there, do not only be satisfied with the Sunday service sermon, which are good, but launch into the deep and look for a cell group, for a life group, for a safe group, where you can join with other believers to encourage one another in this journey. We need each other for our spiritual growth and victory. And until next time, I want to encourage you that you can continue listening to these messages and also inspiring gospel music by dialing this number 563-999-3909. You can also tune in radio and search One Word Miracle Radio. The third way is a smart way. We all love to be smart these days, even technology-wise, in your smartphone. You can download an app. It is free of charge. Just go to your Play Store and type One Word Digital Media. Download it, and it is free of charge. This is your home for your spiritual guidance, your voice of hope. And until next time, I am your presenter, Florence Minor, of Celebrate Your Moment with Joy. God bless you.